Anna Pathak. I hope that everyone of you are doing well there, and I am very excited that everyone of you are here to join with me to learn something, and I am here to teach you science. So before starting the chapter, I would like to say something. Please stay safe and hygienic at your home. And talking about the chapter, we are going to start from chapter 1, and our first chapter is living things and non-living things. Okay, students? So, at the end of the session, you will be able to differentiate between living things and non-living things. And for now, let us go to the chapter. And please look at the board. There are many kinds of things around us. They can be divided into living things and non-living things. Yes, students, just turn around, you can see so many things, isn't it? Among them, some of them are living things, some of them are non-living things. So, at first year, we are going to study about living things. So, do you have any idea about it? What are living things? Think about it. Okay. So, let me explain it for now. Things which have life in them are called living things. Yes, students. The things which have life in them. The things which can move from one place to another place. The things which can grow from small to big. The things which need food to survive. The things which can breathe. The things which can reproduce. Means the things which can give birth to their own kind. Like cow gives birth to a calf, dog gives birth to a puppy, cat gives birth to a kitten, human beings gives birth to a child. So they all are living things. All plants and animals are living things. Yes, each and every plants, trees, animals, birds, insects, human beings, they all are living things. Some living things are found in water, air and on land. Okay, so now look at the picture. Can you see the picture here? What is it? Do you have any idea? It is a tree. Yes, students, it is a tree. It can grow. Tree can grow from small to big. It needs food. Yes, every plants and trees need food, and they can prepare their food by themselves. They use air, water and sunlight to prepare food. And these three are the foods for plants and trees. Okay, students? So it is living things. Got it? That's great. So next one we have here. Can you see the picture? It is a cow. It is a land animal. Yes. Cow lives on land. So it is a land animal. It can grow from small to big and move. Yes. Cow can move from one place to another place. Not only cow, but every animal can move from one place to another place. It needs food. Yes, animals need food to survive. They cannot live without food. Do you know what do cow eat? Cow eats grass. Okay, so it is living things. Got it, students? So now we have completed about living things, and I hope that you have understood about living things. Okay, so moving on to the next one, we have non-living things. Okay, so the things which do not have life in them are called non-living things. Yes, the things which do not have life in them, the things which cannot move from one place to another place, the things which cannot grow, the things which cannot reproduce, the things which cannot breathe, or the things which do not need food to survive, they all are non-living things. All man-made things are non-living things, such as house, door, pencil, etc. Yes, everything that is made by man, they all are man-made things, and we can say them as non-living things also, like house, table, door, fan, book, pen, pencil, they all are made by man. So, they all are man-made things, and we can say them as non-living things also. So, natural things like rock, water, wood and soil are also non-living things. There are some natural things also which are made by nature itself. So, they are also non-living things. So, here again, look at the picture. Can you see the picture here? What is it? It is a house and it do not need food. Do house need food? No, it do not need food. It cannot speak. House cannot speak. It cannot walk. Have you ever seen house walking from one place to another place? No, we haven't seen. Yes. It do not breathe. Yes, house cannot breathe. So, it is non-living things. Okay, students. So, we have completed our first session today. And I hope that now you are able to differentiate between living things and non-living things. We have completed our first session and I have prepared some homeworks for you. Again. So there are two questions altogether. The first one is, what are living things? Give any five examples. What are non-living things? Give any five examples. Okay, so these are your homeworks. Please do your homework on time. And after completing your homework, please do check your homework to your elder one, either your father or mother or your brother or sister. And if you have done any kind of mistake, they will do correction. Okay, so please do your homework on time. Thank you, class.